हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर एस के सोनोनी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ प्लांट पैथोलॉजी फ्रॉम केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर नासिक। माय टुडेज प्रेजेंटेशन टॉपिक अंडर द कोर्स नंबर इलेक्टिव पैथ 243 एंड कोर्स टाइटल बायो फर्टिलाइजर्स, बायो पेस्टिसाइड्स एंड बायो कंट्रोल एजेंट्स। एंड माय टुडेज प्रेजेंटेशन टॉपिक ऑन importance of verticillium lecani, beveria bassiana, metarhizium anisopli, nomuria rilei and pacillomyces lilacinus. Let's we see one by one all the entomopathogenic fungus. First, verticillium lecani. Introduction of verticillium lecani. It is also called as lecanicillium lecani, and it is one of the most important entomopathogenic fungus to control whiteflies, thrips, aphids, mealybugs and other sucking pest. Then what is mean by entomopathogenic fungus? It is an microorganism that specifically infect and often killing insect and pests. Verticillium lecani was first isolated and identified in 1861, and it was found on insects. It is also called as white hollow fungus because of its white mycelial growth present on infected insects. In fungus and insect, the common protective layer is present, that is chitin. And the insect cuticle is made up of lipid, proteins and chitin. So the chitinase enzymes are produced by fungal cell wall for their defense, and these enzymes hydrolyzing the insect cuticular constituents. Let's see the mode of action of verticillium lecani. When we apply the verticillium lecani in farm, and the biopesticide comes in contact with the insect and attached to the cuticle of that host insect. Then the fungal spores are germinate in favorable conditions and grows directly into the inner body of that host insect by taking nutrients of insect and colonize the entire insect and drains the nutrients from that host insect. Then the insect eventually killing within 48 to 72 hours. These are the targeted pest of verticillium. These biopesticides apply for mealybugs, thrips, aphids and majorly for whiteflies. Let's see some benefits of verticillium. This is beneficial entomopathogenic fungus, easily available, eco-friendly and safe for farmers. And it is plays important role in controlling economically important sucking pests. Next entomopathogenic fungus is Beveria bassiana. Introduction of Beveria. It is also called as white muscarding fungus because it causes white muscarding disease in lepidopterian pest. It is used to control sucking pest and different beetles. Then history of Beveria bassiana. It is discovered in 1835 by Italian entomologist Agostino while he was studying the white muscarding disease in silkworms. Beveria bassiana was isolated from silkworms in 1835 by Agostino. Mode of action of Beveria. As usual, fungus comes in contact with the insect in different ways, and best way is application of biopesticide. Then the fungal spore comes in contact of insect cuticle and germinate. After germination, they penetrate their hyphae and rapidly increase in numbers on insect. Then fungus secretes some enzymes which dissolve insect cuticles. When the conditions are favorable, the fungus will enter through softer part of insect and produce the characteristics as white bloom appearance. Here, the growth cycle of Beveria bassiana. First, mycelial growth on insect body, then multiplication and spore formation on insect. All mycelial growth present all over the body of insect. This is the mycelial growth of Beveria bassiana on insect body. Uses of Beveria bassiana. It is used for all major crops for control mealybugs, beetles, moth, hoppers and whiteflies. It has some benefits. It is highly effective against wide range of insect. No phytotoxic effects and can be used in organic farming, and it is safe for humans and environment. Next entomopathogenic fungus is Metarhizium anisopli. Introduction of Metarhizium. It is also known as Entomophthora anisopli, and it was isolated from beetles. These fungus grow naturally and present everywhere and causes diseases in insect. And because of its green color, it is called green muscardine fungus, and cause disease in insect is known as green muscardine disease. Then mode of action of Metarhizium. Let's see the mechanism of Metarhizium. First, adhesion means fungus comes in contact with the insect host. Then germination of spores to produce hyphae. Then the hyphae emerge and penetrate into insect cuticle. Fungus develop inside after few days, and the whole insect covered with fungal spores and eventually kill the host insect. Metarhizium produce insecticidal peptides, that is dextrins. The insect cadaver become red after infection. Fungus spread by insect at the time of mating. Insect cadaver means the dead body of host insect. Then some insect have antifungal properties to suppress the growth of Metarhizium or any entomopathogenic fungus. For example, desert locust have ability to produce antifungal toxins which inhibit the growth and germination of Metarhizium spores. Metarhizium are known to control greater than 200 species in 50 families. It controls various beetles, weevils, flies, ants, grasshoppers and locust. These are the insect which are attacked by Metarhizium. It shows green color growth and sporulation and velvety green growth on insects. Then uses of Metarhizium anisopli. Metarhizium is used as biopesticide to control number of pests, and it is also used to control malaria transmitting mosquitoes. It is also produced some enzymes which are used in different reactions. For example, leafage enzymes are used in biodiesel production. Then let's see the advantages of Metarhizium. It is applied at the time of harvesting also, and it is non-pollutive, eco-friendly and long-term effect on pest suppression. Next entomopathogenic fungus is Nomoria reilly. Introduction of Nomoria. It shows white color growth on PDA media and it control economically important polyphagous insect pest. Then we see how to act nomoria relay. As we see, same as previously said mode of action, fungus comes in contact with the larvae and larval body is completely mummified and covered by white mycelial mat. Under the favorable conditions, spread the fungus and resulting high levels of kill. Then, active enzymes in nomoria relay, it produces variety of enzymes including protease, chitinase, and these enzymes are used for food industries, medicinal use and detergents making. Then we study next entomopathogenic fungus, that is Pseudomyces liliacinus. It shows pink color on PDA media. Pseudomyces liliacinus introduction. Pseudomyces liliacinus is also called as nematophagous fungus because it is effective against melanogyny species of nematodes. It is an important biopesticide that protects the root system against disease caused by plant parasitic nematodes. Then mode of action of Pseudomyces. It have unique mode of penetration of hyphae by fungus and grow inside the nematode body and start feeding on insect internal contents and act as a parasite on nematodes and finally kills the nematodes. This biopesticide or entomopathogenic fungus apply in various ways, that is soil application, seed treatment, seedling treatment. And following are the targeted crops where Pseudomyces liliacinus act as a nematicide. These all are targeted nematode species used for different nematode in different crops. That is root knot nematodes, golden cyst nematodes, citrus nematode, burrowing nematodes and reniform nematodes. Then advantages of nomoria. The advantages of Pseudomyces. The fungus used to control nematode infestation in soil and eco-friendly. It is natural biofungicide, residue free and effective in control of nematode attack. Thank you.